Hi there, DIYers. So today we're going to do an unboxing and review of the YardMax walk behind self-propelled 22 inch lawn mower. Let's get to it. All right, see what we got here. So I ordered this online from Home Depot, paid right at $350. And they shipped it to me in just a couple days. And it's pretty heavy. Let's see what we got in here. Looks pretty well packed. So it's got the collector, which I never use. Some tools and an air filter and manual instructions and all that good stuff. Pull out some of this cardboard. Looks like it's mostly assembled, just like a few things I'll have to do to it to get it running. It's got a little bit of weight to it. Oil has been drained for shipping, so looks like I'll have to add oil. Get this stuff out of the way. So it's a mulching mower, but it also comes with the adapter so you can spray instead of mulch. Let's see. I don't think I'm going to need any instructions. That's what most guys do, right? You don't read instructions until you run into a problem and you're like, oh, okay, let me read. That's the way I am most of the time. Yeah, that's all free spinning. That tightened down. Feels pretty solid. Heavy duty compared to the other. That was like the old Murray mower that I had. Okay. So he's got these quick release and snap in for the. You can actually adjust the height of your handle push area here. This is actually a CVT, is what it says. It's a 6-speed, and you can manually control the gears. And this being rear wheel drive, it's supposed to be better for hills and sides and rougher terrain as opposed to the front wheel drive ones. Every front wheel drive self-propelled mower I've had in the past have all been crap. I mean, they work good at first, but then after a little bit the gears, something gets messed up and they just don't drive anymore. So I'm hoping to have a little better experience with this rear wheel drive one. My first rear wheel drive I've had. So we'll see how that does. This was the largest CC motor for the cheapest price. Most of them were like 150 cc's around there. This is a 201 cc. So, being that a lot of the stuff I'm mowing is thick, really thick stuff, so I wanted a little more torque. So, obviously, I went with the higher cc. So, let's take a look at what we have here. I guess this is the four cycle engine motor. I guess I'll need to read in there to see what the how much oil I need to put in this. But let's just go over a few of the things this has. So again, get this up a little closer. So here it's got the six-speed CVT. Looks like the further you go forward, the more tension there is. But of course, moving forward is the faster it'll go. It's got 1 through 6. It's got turtle for 1 and a rabbit for 6. Anything in between, you can pick the species, I reckon. And so looks like one is for starting and the other one is for the drive. This one is for starting, the top one. And then the bottom one is for the drive, which makes sense. So you get that started. Okay. And down here, this actually is the height adjustment. So you just push towards, pull outward, you can adjust the height level. If I do mine at, see, 1, 2, 3, if I do it at 3 or 4, and look at that, it's got a armature on this side here that's connected to the rear. So when you adjust the rear, it automatically adjusts the front. So, isn't that convenient? That's pretty special. I like that. That's nice. Got foil here over the gas. I guess it's protecting it from any impurities getting in during shipping. This has got muscle fuel level. Interesting. So I guess that'll start lifting up when you get the fuel at the right or up towards full. Okay. I think it's pretty well all together. I just need to put the oil in. So let me read, see how much oil it actually takes. Well, it's got a dipstick over here. Get this little funnel out here. Guess I need to check, see if it came with an air filter here. Let me see, it's already got one in it. And it does, look at that. So good. So I got a replacement air filter already. And looks like a plug of some sort. Guess I'll need to read up on that, see what that's all about. Alright, let me turn this back around here. Guess we can see. Alright. There is no oil in it at the moment. It only comes with a half of a bottle of oil. That's 17 fluid ounces, so with it being half, it's like 8.5 fluid ounces. This lid's stuck on there good. It's got some kind of foil on it as well. Wow. And that is on there good. Let's see. It's a nice clear oil. This must be a synthetic. Doesn't say, it just says premium four cycle 10W30. Yeah. All right, let's check the oil level. Not seeing it yet. Put some fuel in it. Let's take a look at the underside first before we do. Let's like see what kind of stuff's going on down here. Okay, yeah. Standard mulching blade. And looks like it's got, this must help with the mulching, the move stuff around. Oh, actually I think that, oh. Okay, now I know what's going on. That orange plug is, looks like it's a replacement for the mower deck wash. Because it's got a wash port. I've got that on my big rider mower and my other push mower. I've never used it. Never really had a need to, I guess. So yeah, right here's the deck wash. You just hook the hose up to it so that other orange piece was looks like a replacement connector for it. Get this. All right, so let's get some just regular unleaded fuel in here. This is the first YardMax mower I've ever bought. I think I've had a weed eater, one of their weed whackers before, which seemed to work pretty well. But definitely the first mower. I'm not particular on any brand necessarily. I've had a lot of different ones. And most of these mowers use Briggs & Stratton. This is actually a YardMax OEM engine. It's overhead V engine, so it says a quick start, just go and mow. So no priming, no choke, just go and mow. I got some oil dripping on the side there. Let me get that wiped up here real quick. So yeah, so the handle height, it's got three handle heights. So it's, I've got it at the highest at the moment, and it'll go down two more. So we'll see what that does. Yeah, so it's just a full start. Now imagine I have to have this compressed here, because that moves this actuator in for it to engage.
Second pass.
How about that? Second pull and it started. Just from coming from shipping. That's pretty good. All right. Well, see what. Let's get you positioned where you can see better. Actually, tell you what, let's switch over to my chest rig. Yeah, there we go. I've got this chest rig that I can use to put the camera on, and then you get the first person view, or POV, point of view. So, here we are with that. I'll angle this down just slightly. So let's get this thing fired up and get a little bit of some of this down here mode. All right, so. Thank you. All right, take this back off. All right. First opinions, first thoughts. When I was over there in that brush, it's like this thing did not bog down hardly at all. It just plowed through it. And there was some thick sticks and things in there, and it just whacked right through it. I really loved the self-propelled. It surprised me because the other ones being front-wheel drive, especially, I guess, with there not being a lot of weight on the front wheels, sometimes they're just sitting there spinning, and so you have to kind of help push to get it, those wheels to pick up. With the rear-wheel drive, having the larger wheels, they're biting in, and I was surprised how well it was tracking off. And even in the turtle mode, number one, it goes fairly quick, and I was actually pretty impressed with how fast it was actually going. I had it at 6. I mean, yeah, you're cruising, so you're smoking through that lawn pretty quick. So I'm pretty happy with this thing. But as it cleared through all that thick brush, I was amazed how well that the mower stayed at the constant speed and didn't bog down. But I always had that problem with my mowers in the past, is that when you're getting over anything, you know, thicker brush, if you don't mow your grass every week, how you get, you know, a couple weeks worth of growth gets pretty thick, and you have to go slower, bogs down. This thing seems like it's just going to plow right through that stuff. So I'd definitely give this a 2 thumbs up, and I think this is going to serve me well. It's like, keep it well maintained and cleaned up, and keep it well oiled, and it ought to last me a good bit. But hey, for $350 compared to some of the other things that are out there, I think this is definitely a good purchase. And the rear wheel drive, it's what I needed initially for any mower that I've had that was self-propelled, because the front wheel drive, I think, is just a crap idea. I mean, great for cars, and it would be good for this if it was on pavement, but you're not mowing pavement, so rear-wheel drive definitely seems like the way to go. And yeah, good stuff. Anyway, if you like this video, appreciate you to like and subscribe, and got more videos coming. Stay tuned.